Ah, there you are. The Waterdeep emissary arrived here not long ago, safe and sound. Well done. He told quite a tale about your heroic rescue. Couldn't stop singing your praises. I can't wait to hear your version of the tale. Ah, and you brought Logrum's Eye Gouger's banner. That would explain why the orc attacks have stopped. Without a chieftain, they're going to be fighting each other now. She did indeed. She claimed to have been part of the force attacking the orcs. She's here in the camp, along with some of her men. It was her leader I was waiting for, and I see you've brought him. Well met, Casavir.
Callum, it is good to see you're still in one piece. Yes, Callum serves Neverwinter. As I did for a time.
I assume you were the one leading that band who was harassing the orcs. I owe you a great debt. Now that I know who is leading that mercenary band, I understand why it was so difficult for us to make contact with you. You've put me in a difficult position here, Casavir. Your leaving was sudden, and some even say disloyal to Neverwinter.
I cannot have you defend me in this, but I thank you for your words.
No harm will come to him, I assure you. My report will read that the Greycloaks were able to hold off the orcs long enough for you to take Logrum's head. That should make the council happy that their money was well spent, and put you in good graces with them as well. And officially, Casavir was never here. Whatever reasons you had for leaving and going on to Old Owl Well, they are your own.
I thank you, but I will do my best to ensure you are not drawn into my troubles. Rest assured that I doubt anyone looks for me still. I left Neverwinter's service, and the matter is not more complicated than that.
What of my soldiers, Callum? They know Old Owlwell, and they fight as only those fighting for their homes will fight.
I could certainly use them if they don't mind wearing a uniform, my friend. My Greycloaks could certainly learn a thing or two from them. Of course, I'm going to have a hard time explaining to the council how I ended up with another 100 mouths to feed and arm. The emissary is under my protection now. I'll send my best soldiers to escort him. You've already risked enough for him. You've done more than your share of work here. I've taken the liberty of putting together a reward for you. Consider it a gift from the council. You have my thanks for everything that you've done here. And keep an eye on Casavir for me, will you? I hope you can help him. Back to work for me. It was good seeing you again, Casavir. Good luck to you. Oh, and you may want to go see your friend, Catriona, if you haven't already. I'm sure she'd like to make sure you're all right.
It's good to see you again, Casavir. I heard you found Logrum.
We did. I am glad you were able to make it here to warn Callum. If we had failed, there would have been little keeping Logrum and all the tribes from retaking this place.
Any new orders? Even with the tribes in disarray, you and I could probably help with the Greycloaks, if you wanted.
No. The orcs no longer hold Old Owlwell. It has been freed for the people here, not solely for a Neverwinter trade route.
Going to leave just the way you arrived, are you, Casavir? So, where does that leave me? It might be time for me to find something a little more challenging. These orcs were tough, but, well, I think I'm due for a change of scenery. Maybe there's a nobleman in Neverwinter who needs an extra blade by their side.
She's quite capable. I couldn't have asked for a finer sergeant.
For now, I think I'll stay here. Maybe they can use someone like me until I feel like making the journey to Neverwinter. Could be a while. If you decide you need help, come see me. Maybe we can work something out. Back again? It might be time for me to find something a little more challenging. These orcs were tough, but, well, I think I'm due for a change of scenery. Maybe there's a nobleman in Neverwinter who needs an extra blade by their side.
She's quite capable. I couldn't have asked for a finer sergeant.
For now, I think I'll stay here. Maybe they can use someone like me until I feel like making the journey to Neverwinter. Could be a while. If you decide you need help, come see me. Maybe we can work something out.
Yes.
Perhaps so. Stay close and step where I step.
Well, now, if it isn't my harborman kin, what can Uncle Duncan do for you? Only as much as Dagon allows. He keeps his past close, despite how it keeps everyone else from him. I knew your mother, though. I know you lost her early. Terrible tragedy. During that attack on the village. But that's really Dagon's place to say, not mine.
There you are. I've been meaning to chat with you. You've helped me and Dory out of some scrapes, so I wanted to thank you proper. I've got a proposition for you. I heard you're friends with the owner of the sunken flagon. Me and my mates could really use a roof over our heads at night.
A roof would be so good.
So the deal is, we'll help you out, and you convince your friend to let us stay in the flagon. Deal? Fellow companions of the road, young lads and lasses that ain't got no kitsch to call their own, we'll help you out too. I'm glad we've come to an agreement then. Dory, myself, and the rest will be by the sunken flagon. See you back at the flagon then.
Bye.
message for you, if you got time to hear it, and aren't in a hitting mood. It's for her, the girl with the tail it is, the one who sounds like a sneeze.
Ooh, I've never had anyone deliver a message for me before. Well, unless it's a threat, or a severed limb.
It's from one Lulden, big fellow in the merchant quarter. Says he wants to see you both, he does. Wants to meet you both in the park. Says he'll be waiting for you and the fiend girl. Without her, he doesn't show. Smells like a trap to me.
Come on, let's meet him. It'll be fun. Everybody, follow me!
Nishka, long time.
Lulden, it's been nowhere near long enough. You know, I tried to visit you the other night, but you slept right through it. Truth told, I'm surprised you even had the spine to come here, seeing you can't even steal a coin from me and keep it. Now where could it have gone?
Give it back to me, girl.
Always with the threats. Why can't you admit you just lost, Lulden? You'll never be as good a cut purse as me, ever.
I don't need to compete with you. Just kill you. Of course she did, because it is her coin. It's worthless, but it seems to drive her crazy not having it, so I've kept it close by all this time in the hope she'll come crawling back for it. And here she is, just in time to die.
Yeah, you don't have me outnumbered like last time. So if you want to fight, then come on. We'll carve you into bits.
All right, men. You heard the lady.
We won't... Now, strike swiftly. Now, strike swiftly.
This isn't over, I swear it.
Phew, stupid smoke potions. He always does that when he's lost a fight. The coward. Still, that should have taught him a lesson. He'll never call me Goat Girl again. Hey, thanks for your help. We'd better get out of here before more of his men show up.
Thank you. Stay close and step where I step.
Something you need? They were in the mood to threat. It's a shame they didn't keep it a friendly fight. All right, go on and ask them. Huh? What about it? Huh? What? You like switching words around? That makes no sense at all. It makes no sense. It's wordplay. Riddles. Huh? Maybe. I'm not making any promises, but if you can make good on it, then I'll chew it over. Yes. All right, go on and ask them. Huh? Like who? Well, that frail lass is one of the copper elves. Wood elves. They're a stone's throw more tolerable than some of the other kin, but she's still an elf. Their kind stood with the shield dwarves in the north, so I'll stand by her if need be. She needs to comb her hair, though, and put a little meat on that slim belly of hers. You'd think she was trying to be a tavern dancer with a belly like that. Huh, makes my stomach churn. Huh? Not a bad idea. All right, go on and ask them. Well, there's a great deal to tell, especially if we're going with clan history and our accomplishments. But chances are, and I don't blame you, you're just asking about me, personally. So let me give you the short version. I've been making my trade at taverns as well, but you already had a taste of that at the Weeping Willow.
Our companion Kelgar mentioned West Harbor to me. I heard what happened there. To your friends, the other villagers. The attack by those creatures that forced you to leave. Still, to leave your home. I sometimes forget the attachments one can put to a place. With my kind, especially those that listen to nature, there is no one place that we call home. Everywhere we go throughout the land is comforting with its own sounds and life. I can see how that would be. It is a strange concept at times, but understandable. We deal with few outside of our own circle. I have not seen my own kind in many years, and I spoke with the circle only rarely. But surely we were not here to discuss how I feel about things. Was there something you needed? What did you wish to know? It is not something I wish to discuss. Let us leave it for another time. If there is something else you wish to ask, then do so. But there are some things which shall remain mine and mine alone. I was the one who sent the animals of the forest to your aid, though there are fewer of them to answer my call than in days past. And yes, I summoned nature to aid you when the second group attacked. It is not something I can explain, but I feel these creatures pursue you for a reason. Where you walk, so do they. You are either a threat or prey to them, and I must discover which. These creatures that hound you are responsible for other crimes. Much rides on this, both from the past and the present. I was uncertain of your goals and your intentions, and whether you are some ally of these creatures. Only during the later stages of the attack did I feel compelled to intervene. It is always in our nature to watch, to observe. To act is at times difficult. It is not something I wish to discuss. Let us leave it for another time. If there is something else you wish to ask, then do so. But there are some things which shall remain mine and mine alone. What did you wish to know? The mare is no longer a place I know well. And where it once teemed with life, now it has fallen silent. Something stirs there, but I know not what. It was not always the case. I have spent many years in its depths, learning its ways. And there was much to learn, always. It's a tale for another time, and there are more pressing concerns. Perhaps in time we may discuss it further. What did you wish to know? Do you think this is the first lifetime I have spent in the mists of Merdelaine? My life in the mare dates back several lifetimes. Many of my ancestors lie beneath its waters, and my ancestors were there when Merdelaine gained its human name, before there were even such tiny settlements as West Harbor and Red Fallow's Watch. The name means nothing to you, does it? Of course not. The mare claimed it over 50 years ago in its slow march across the land, and before that was the event where it gained its human name. My people once called the mare Merdelaine, the slow tide, or slow marching court, in the times before the wars of men gave it a new name, before humans settled on its shores. And those settlements are mostly gone now. Their manors and castles now ruins, desperately reaching their hands above the water. It is for all who dwell within cities that the land will take again what was taken from it, whether cut stone, carved wood, or fields sliced by the plow. No, for my father perished there in the fog, slain by orc soldiers from the mountains. It is his life that I speak of when I say lifetimes. On the year the swamp gained its new name, there was a great battle fought miles within its borders. Orcs spilling from the mountains drove humans, dwarves, and my people into the swamps where they were surrounded and cut down in the fog, trapped in mud where the footings of the orcs proved truer. But there were no need for graves. Their corpses were all embraced and dragged down, and what dead lay upon the surface were taken by the others who dwelled in the swamp. And so, even in the fog, the ghosts still whisper and weep of lost Merdelaine, the song taken up by countless elven widows that cry across its shores. And always, the mare seeks more dead to draw them down into its waters, down amongst the dead ones. I was orphaned from that battle when the first of the circle found me wailing in the mist, in those very ruins you traveled to outside of West Harbor. They gathered me up and I made no sound, and they took me into the heart of the mare to show me its secret ways. And there was always much to learn. In time, though I knew only some of its ways, I became accepted into the circle, and accepted by the mare as well. It was only the last test that I failed. Perhaps we shall speak of it another time, but not now.
What's going on? Yeah? Which one of the marks you wanted to know about? Not the barrelhead dwarf, is it? Well, he needs to watch his tongue, or it's gonna run right out of his mouth and get stepped on. I mean, you did me a good turn. All I want to do is help out, and he's yelling at me like some old mule. I know he's short, and it's rough being in the big people's world. But he needs to stop being all defensive, especially for someone so small. Story of my life. You'd be surprised how much you hear that when you're about to be burned at the stake or run out of the local hamlet. He's too quick to start fights, that's his problem. He keeps it up, he's not going to have anyone watching his back. Or more likely, looking over it. Questions. Go ahead. I'm all horns. Yeah? Which one of the marks you wanted to know about? Not the barrelhead dwarf, is it?
The tree worshiper?
What about her?
If you're asking if she has any money or valuables, then no. I already checked. I don't know. She's got pointy ears, but doesn't smell of the lower plains, so she's probably not a tiefling. And she's too tall to be a halfling, and too thin. Plus, she hangs out with animals, so she's an elf. What do you expect me to say? She's one of those nature priests. worship trees and the land, don't like cities, so don't have much traffic with her kind.
Welcome back, Lieutenant. Do you have anything to report? You have done well, Lieutenant. I knew my faith was not misplaced. You are to be commended for your efforts on Neverwinter's behalf. Your efforts at the docks have greatly improved the position of the watch, but it has also drawn new predators.
Predators from Luskan.
Luskan is one of our less benevolent neighbors. We have had troubles with them in the past.
A war, actually. No need to hedge words when it comes to their kind. Now those Luskan cowards are attempting to take advantage of your success at the docks to put spies in our midst.
We have caught word that one of their agents is attempting to enter port on board a merchant vessel from Luskan. A vessel called the Sea Ghost. We need you to go to the docks, board the Sea Ghost, and stop the Luskans. Return here when you have accomplished your mission. We need you to board the Sea Ghost at the docks and deal with the Luskans, Lieutenant. Return here when you have accomplished your mission.
And what news do you bring from Old Owlwell, Lorne? Do Grey Cloak and bodies now lie in the hands of the Shadow Priests?
No, my lord. There were difficulties. An adventurer...
You have failed me, yet dare to return? I asked you to keep the priests safe. Without them, there will be no ritual. All I asked of you was to put pressure on the Neverwinter forces. Cut off their trade routes through the mountains. Yet all you have given Neverwinter is hope. And a victory at Old Owlwell, which will allow them to concentrate on other fronts.
Fortlock and Highcliff still remain ours, Lord Garius. Neverwinter's attention will be focused there, not upon us.
Fort Locke and Highcliff, yes. Obviously, you have not heard, but our position there has become weaker, not stronger. And now you have come to tell me Old Owlwell has fallen, and the priests there are dead. Perhaps I shall allow you to be the one to tell the King of Shadows the news. Is that your wish, Lorne?
My Lord Darius, forgive me. It shall not happen again. I swear upon my life.
In that, Lorne, you are correct.
A common adventurer outmaneuvered you, Lorne. You really are losing your touch.
Bite your tongue, Torio, or I'll rip it from your throat.
He won't stop me a second time.
Oh, of course he won't, Lorne. With your luck, chances are next time, he'll just kill you.
Take!
and this'll all be over.
Yes? Is there something you wish of me? I went there because I felt my sword could make a difference. No other reason. There was a need for action, the need to set an example. To move Neverwinter to act is something beyond my strength. But a greater good has been accomplished, and you have shown that to me. I went alone because I had to. Battling the tribes of the old Owlwell is something that must be done. It is simple, a necessary act. There is no doubt as to what must be done. No conflicts. There are battles that can be fought and others that cannot. It is a difficult thing to speak of. I appreciate your words and your intentions, but this is something that is difficult to share. Perhaps another time, when the words are easier to find. I appreciate your efforts, but this battle is of a different sort. It is something within, and until I find the words for it, there is little that can be done.
We have heard of your success at the Sea Ghost. You are to be commended.
Taking care of that ship did not get rid of all the Luskans, but it hurt them. And that's good enough for me.
I hope that none of the Luskans escaped your notice. They tend to hold grudges. Here you are, the reward for your efforts. It was a dangerous mission, and you did well.
Lieutenant, I have just received word from the Nine. They believe assassins are in Neverwinter, and have asked for our help in dealing with them. There was some hesitation in them asking for our assistance. The incidents in the docks have caused questions. I am not sure they trust our ability. Yet we have the location, and I'm giving you your orders. Proceed to the merchant quarter and deal with the situation. If they pose a threat to Neverwinter, I want their presence here removed. Go now, prepare yourself, and report back here when you've dispatched this threat to Neverwinter.
Lorne, I've been waiting for your report.
Oh, but Master, look, Lorne's face is sad. Has he had a setback?
My lord, there has been trouble at the docks.
Trouble? Oh, Lorne, please.
Silence, Dorio. Let Lorne speak.
Of course, Garrius. I meant no disrespect.
The City Watch has become organized. They're taking command of the docks, and they jeopardize our position there. Several of our agents have been killed, others driven off.
Curious. This is a rather sudden turn of events, Lorne.
I can fix it, my lord. I swear to you.
I did not gain my title of Master of the Fifth Tower by drowning Luskan in blood, and I do not wish you to do the same to the docks. It is an unfortunate setback, but one I think we can still repair, provided we use the right tool.
And this'll all be over.
We won't both walk away from the...
That's it.
Abio no.
Gori Kaporos.
Walk away from this.
That's it.
Of course.
Of Merdelaine.
Yeah.
Everyone, follow me!
That house was warm.
My steel will strike true!
Hells, hells, hells! Was that all right?
Maria, Rocco!
Showed up.